Good morning, students. Welcome to the session. In this session, I am going to discuss the infinite resistance questions. These types of questions are always asked in any exam like CBSE, NEET and JEE exam. So basically, what you have to do here in this type of question, I will tell you the logic and then you have to follow that logic. So students, without wasting any time, we are starting the session. And so first question is this is Jaskirat at this end, and the first question is we have to find the resistance between point A. This is point A and this is point B. So we have to find the resistance between point A and B when this is 10 ohm resistance, this is 10 ohm, this is again 10 ohm resistance, again 10 ohm and 10 ohm, and this series is continued up to infinity. So I am telling you how to handle this type of questions. This type of questions is always seen in examination. So what we have to do here, we will draw a circuit corresponding to it. That circuit will be like this is point A. Okay, I will start from here. So this is point A and the resistance 10 ohm. Then another resistance that has value 10 ohm. So students, you have to see what I am doing here. This is point A and this is point B. Now students, this has value 10 ohm as given in the question, and this value is also 10 ohm. Now students, what I have to see from the circuit, that where the circuit is repeating after this line, that means after this 10 ohm and this 10 ohm, the whole circuit is repeating. This combination is again repeating here 10 and 10, here 10 and 10, and so on. So that means after this repetition, I am making a resistance that I can write R. Students, remember R ko aapne kahan pe lena hai, ye aapne dhyan rakhna hai. जहाँ से सर्किट रिपीट हो, लाइक 10 एंड 10, दिस सर्किट इज सिमिलर टू द अर्लियर वन, सो इसके बाद हम आर लेंगे, इसका ध्यान रखना. कई बार गलती हो जाती है, बट वी हैव टू टेक केयर. पहले दिस 10, फर्स्टली दिस 10, देन सेकंड 10, एंड देन द रेस्ट सर्किट इज आर, वेयर आर इज द इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द कॉम्बिनेशन. वेयर आर इज द इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द गिवन कॉम्बिनेशन. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, R is equivalent resistance, and how we can find the value of R after this circuit? I will draw one more circuit that will be like this one. Parallel combination of this R and this 10 will make what value? We have to calculate it. So its value is 1 by R plus 1 by 10. So after solving it, it is equal to 1 by RP. On the left hand side, we will get 10R as LCM, 10R, and in the numerator, I will get 10 plus R. Now I have to make the reciprocal of it so that I get the value of RP. So now I am drawing a circuit for AB, this 10 ohm resistance. Then parallel combination of R and 10 will give me a resistance. So this is point A, this is point B. Now this is 10 ohm and the value, this is 10R by 10 plus R. I am taking now reciprocal. So reciprocal will be 10R by 10 plus R. So students, up to this point the question has been solved. You can see फर्स्टली वी हैव टेकन द रेपिटेशन, वेयर द रेपिटेशन इज हैपनिंग, सो मार्क इट एज अ आर, वेयर आर इज द इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ कॉम्बिनेशन. देन वी टेक आर एंड टेन इन पैरेलल, दिस विल मेक 10R बाय 10+R. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स दीज टू आर इन सीरीज, सो आवर नेक्स्ट सर्किट टू दिस 10R, दिस सर्किट इज वन रेजिस्टेंस हैविंग वैल्यू this plus this, so that means this value will be 10R by 10+R, okay, 10+R plus 10. So you can take the LCM now, after the LCM 10R, so its value will be, let me check, 10R 100 plus 20, so its value is 100 plus 20R, 10R plus 10R, 20R by 100 plus 20R by 10+R. Students, now what we have to assume, we will assume that in the beginning when we take R here, after the addition of these two resistances, the equivalent resistance of circuit remains R. This we have to consider. We are taking R here, but we have to consider after this parallel combination of R and 10, and with this 10, the combination does not change, that means the resistance remains R. This we have to consider. So in a simple way you can say this combination resistance does not change by eliminating these two. Baki circuit sare ko hum R consider karenge. After considering R, R ke sath two resistances consider karenge to bhi circuit ki resistance R hi rahegi, we assume it. Then ab kya hoga students, now what will happen, we will make a quadratic equation. So this is the net resistance, that is equal to 100 by 20, or 100 plus 20R by 10+R. So what we do here, we make a quadratic equation. The last value was 100 plus 20R by 10+R. So we consider it that this value is equal to R, where R is the net resistance. So we consider it that the two resistance does not affect the resistance of the circuit. So after this we have this combination, after this combination we have this series combination. The series value is 100 plus 20R by 10+R. So this value we are writing equal to R. After solving you will get 10R plus R square. This is the right hand side, but I have written it on the left hand side. That is equal to 100 plus 20R. Okay. So now you can see equation, quadratic equation will be becoming R square minus 10R minus 100. So this will be the equation. Any factors, if possible, then you can make the factors. Equation is right, R square minus 20R minus 100. Yes, equation is right. Now we have to make its factor. If factors are not possible, then we find the discriminant. Because I think factors are not possible, 20, 10, 100, 10, 10, 100. 25 is the 100. I think factors are not possible. So we find the discriminant. Discriminant is equal to b square. So b square is 10 square minus 10 square. So it will become 100. B square minus 4ac. Minus 4 into a into c, a is 1 and c is minus 100. दिस यू हैव कैलकुलेटेड इफ यू नो यू आर मैथ स्टूडेंट देन यू कैन इजीली कैलकुलेट सो इट्स वैल्यू इज डिस्क्रिमिनेट इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट 500. नाउ टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ आर जस्ट वेट 500 विल बी हियर टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ आर वी हैव टू वैल्यूज वन इज आर वी कैन फाइंड द आर वैल्यू बाय राइटिंग इक्वल टू माइनस बी सो माइनस ऑफ माइनस 10 प्लस माइनस अंडर रूट 500 बाय 2 सो आफ्टर दिस यू कैन सी आर इज इक्वल टू 10 प्लस माइनस अंडर रूट 500 by 2. Students, if we take here minus under 500, then answer will be negative. So we have to take only positive value. So we take 10 plus under root 500 by 2. So this will be our answer for this question. 10 plus under root 500 by 2. This is the value of R. So equivalent resistance for this combination that was given in the question is 10 plus under root 500 by 2. You can see the question, I am repeating. From here, you have to see the repetition. You have to make these two resistance, then parallel resistance with it is R. Now this R and 10 will make this combination, parallel combination, and value of equivalent resistance will be 10R by 10 plus R. This will be in series with this 10, so they are simply added. And we assume after this addition, its resistance will still remain R. The addition of two resistances will not change the resistance of circuit. This we consider. Then by putting this last value equal to R, we get a quadratic equation. And then we have solved it. Its vectors were not possible. So we find it by the discriminant method that you have studied in your 10th class. So I think first question is clear. Can I move to the second question now? First question is clear. You can check if any doubts are there, then you can ask. Okay. So now we are moving to second question. Wait for 1 minute. So now students, we are with the second question. In the second question, the some resistances are given and there is some change. This resistance is also included. So I will solve this question similar to the earlier question. So after this portion, the circuit is repeating. After this portion, three resistances, further three resistances, further up to infinity. So what we have to do here, I will make a circuit from it. So the circuit next to this circuit will be this resistance of 4 ohm. This is also 4 ohm. Students, basically you have to understand the concept. If you understand the concept, then you can do any type of such question. So it is 4 and 4 here. This is point A and this is point B. What I will do now, I will make another resistance in parallel whose value is equal to R, where R is the equivalent resistance of circuit. I hope now it is clear how to make a circuit from infinite circuit. Then students, we have to solve this one. Now the next circuit to this circuit will be parallel combination of R and 4 will give me the value of 5 by 4 R. Let me solve it 1 by R. So you have to follow the same steps in every question, but the circuit may be changed some. So here 4, so its equivalent will be equal to 4 after taking the LCM, 4 by 4 plus R by 4 R. दिस वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू 1/RP, दिस वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू 1/RP. सो वट वी हैव टू डू, आई हैव टू टेक रेसिप्रोकल. सो नाउ आई एम ड्रॉइंग अ सर्कट नेक्स्ट टू दिस सर्कट, पॉइंट ए रेजिस्टेंस 4, देन अ पैरेलल रेजिस्टेंस हियर दैट इज ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम द टू रेजिस्टेंसेस 4 एंड R. सो दिस विल बी द नेक्स्ट सर्कट. हियर वी विल राइट द वैल्यू ऑफ RP. RP विल बी 4R. यू हैव टू टेक केयर दैट यू विल सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली, सो नो मिस्टेक विल बी देयर. 4R/4+R. सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. इट हैज़ वैल्यू 4 एंड इट हैज़ वैल्यू 4. दिस इज पॉइंट ए एंड दिस इज पॉइंट बी. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वट यू हैव टू डू आफ्टर दिस सर्कट, यू विल ड्रॉ नेक्स्ट सर्कट. नाउ दिस 3, दिस 1, दिस 1 एंड दिस 1, दिस ऑल 3 आर इन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन. सो यू विल सिंपली एड इट एंड मेक अ 1 रेजिस्टेंस whose value is equal to 4R/4+R. Then two resistances of 4 ohm and R in series, so +4 this resistance is also equal to R, where R is the equivalent resistance. So earlier as we solved first question, we are assuming that after addition of the three resistances with R, the resistance of the circuit remains R. Only this is the way in which this is the only way by using which we can find the value of infinite the resistance of infinite resistance. Infinite resistances are in circuit. So only this way is there. So now we have to make a quadratic equation, so I will write it in a vertical line so that we can solve it easily. So after solving it, you can write, you will see 4R here, 4R+8/4 32 plus 8R, 4R equal to 4R. मे बी इट्स फैक्टर विल बी पॉसिबल ऑल्सो, कहीं पे फैक्टर स्टूडेंट्स बनेंगे कहीं पे नहीं भी बनेंगे. लेट मी सी इन दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाट विल हैपन. सो आई थिंक 4R+8 8×4 42, 8×R 8R, देन 4×R 4R+R². सो दिस 4R 4R विल कैंसिल आउट. वी आर लेफ्ट विद द इक्वेशन R² -8R -32. I am taking both to the right hand side, so it will be -32 equal to 0. See, factors are possible. 8×4 32, 16×2 32. I think factors are not again not possible. So what I will do, I will take again discriminant method. Discriminant is equal to b² - 4ac. So b² is 8×8 = 64, -8×8 = 64, -4ac. Now a is 1 and c is -32, so 32×4 = 128. So its value is 164 plus 128. So students, after this you have to solve it. So its value comes out to be 192. Then we have to solve it by finding the value R equal to -b. Now -b is -8. You can check the equation from by pausing the screen. +/√192. 2, then we have 2a. So again in this case you can see here minus minus will become positive, minus minus will become positive, it will be becoming plus 8, it will become plus 8, let me change the mark, okay, it will become plus 8, minus minus plus, and this should be also plus, because if we take it negative then our resistance will be negative. So your final answer for this question is plus 8 plus under root 192 by root 2. So this will be your final answer. Now I am taking one question from the book S.L. Arora so that we can see our answers are right. Now students, I hope you can see the question number 3.21. So you can see this question and I hope this question will be very much clear to you. So students, what I have to do here today, the resistance, we have to find the determine the current drawn from the battery 12 volt supply with the internal resistance 0.5 ohm by the following infinite network. So each resistance has value 10, 1 ohm is given. So after this circuit or battery is connected here, so you can see here, after this portion we will write the next resistance as R. So we will see the solution, solution is provided here, so we will see the solution, after that we will discuss our method. So students, what you have to see here, okay, so we have to find the resistance, battery of 12 volt is connected between terminal A and B and the internal resistance is 0.5 batteries. So what do you mean by internal resistance? Now more concepts will be there as we do the questions. So internal resistance means here if a battery is connected, then battery has internal resistance, that means there is some resistance of battery also. So this will be the resistance of 0.5. But basically, first of all, you have to understand the method, that what is following, he is following here. So now I am going to show you the solution part. So this was all about the just wait for a moment. Okay, so this is the solution part. Up to this, let the equivalent resistance of network be X. He has taken X. The network consists of infinite units of three resistance, 1 ohm, 1 ohm, 1 ohm. The addition of one more such unit. All you need to ideal resistance, this is set. So students, this he has added here X, you can see X here, 1 ohm resistance. So firstly he had calculated the resistance, now equivalent resistance, then he has connected battery. So first he calculated X by using the similar method that we have used. So this is equal to X. He has made a quadratic equation here, and after that he has solved its value. Then he has find the value of current. But to find the resistance, we have to use the same method that we have used. So this is the resistance. He has also used the discriminant method because factors of this equation are not possible. So I will go to my questions now. I will show you two more questions so that we can understand the concept. Okay. So now I am going back to my questions. So these two questions we have done. Okay, I have to change the frame. Okay, I hope now question is visible. Okay, wait for a moment. Okay students, so now we have done two questions. First one was, we have seen, this was the second one. Now we are going to next question. So our next question will be, फ्रॉम दिस पीडीएफ वी विल टेक. सो आई एम टेकिंग माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एज दिस वन. पेंट कंट्रोल ऑल कॉपी कंट्रोल अनदर. So students, this is our next question. We will see it. Let me settle it. So students, this is our second question and we are going to solve it. Battery is connected here, 2 ohm resistance, 2 ohm, 1 ohm. So this is the combination that is given. So it is our question number 3. And I hope the questions we have done up to this point will be clear to you. So now this is our question number 3. Students, what we have to do here, we will simply draw a circuit from C, from where the circuit is repeating. So circuit is repeating from this point. So draw a circuit, that is next one. It is resistance 1, it is resistance 2, and it is the resistance R. I am not connecting battery here. Battery I will connect later on. It is 2, it is R, and it is 1. So now we will solve this question. So this was the circuit drawn after this one. So now R and 1 are in parallel. So that means the circuit next to it will be, the circuit next to this circuit will be like this one, starting from here, 2 ohm resistance, then another resistance having some value, so it is value 2 ohm. This resistance is the combination of this 1 ohm and this R, so its value is 1 plus, because 1 reciprocal is 1, so I can write it as 1 by 1 plus 1 by R is equal to 1 by RP. That means this RP will be equal to R. After taking the reciprocal, I am writing the value R plus R by R plus R, R by R plus 1. This is the value, this is point A and this is point B. So after this step, this will be the next step. I hope the all steps are clear. I am repeating again. Wait for 1 minute. Okay, control. So I am repeating again. Firstly, we have this circuit. After this point, this 2 ohm resistance and this 1 ohm, the circuit is repeating. So we take it as R, where R is the equivalent resistance of circuit. After this point, we have calculated the, we have drawn the second circuit. After it, we have drawn the third circuit. This R and 1 in parallel, so its value is R by R plus 1. Now these two are in series. Now these two, 2 ohm resistance and this 2 ohm and this R by R plus 1. These two are in series. So we write it as, now we have to make the quadratic equation also, so we write it as 2 plus R by R plus 1 equal to, so we take it equal to R, because adding 1 or 2 resistance will not affect the equivalent resistance. So I hope it is clear. Now we have to make the quadratic equation by taking the LCM, left hand side R, 2R, 2R plus 1 plus 2, 2 into R, 2 into 1 plus 2 plus R equal to R square plus R. Now R and R will cancel out, so we are left with the equation, that is R square minus 2R minus 2.
So this is equal to 0. Again, factors are not possible here. So in this such type of questions, factors will not make. So you have to remember the discriminant formula. So discriminant is equal to b square minus 4ac. So b square is minus 2 square, that will be equal to 4. 4 minus 4ac, 4, a's value is 1 and the value of c is minus 2. So 4 to the 8, discriminant comes out to be under root 12. Under root 12, we can write it as 2 to the 4, 4 3 is the 12, so 2 root 3 we can write it. 2 root 3. Now students, solving this question further to find the value of r, we will write it equal to r equal to minus b, so minus minus 2, b's value is minus 2, so minus minus 2 plus minus under root d, so under root d is this one, d is equal to this, so this we have calculated under root d. Discriminant equal to b square minus 4ac, under root d is this value, so 2 root 3. This is the value of discriminant. Now by 2, so its value comes out to be, the value of r comes out to be 1 plus 1, 1 plus minus under root 3. So this will be the value of resistance. So students, if you see, if we take it as negative, if we take it as negative, then our resistance will be negative. So we don't take it negative, we take it as positive. And our equivalent resistance comes out to be 1 plus 1.73. So 2.73 will be the effective resistance. 2.73 will be the effective resistance of this infinite circuit. I am repeating the concept again. You can see from the beginning. In the beginning, the circuit was given to me when the battery is connected here. Firstly, I will find the resistance, then I will use the battery concept. So after this point, after this circuit, the circuit is again repeating 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. So then I take it as R. Now this R and 1 is in parallel combination, so it will give me 1/RP. Then after 1/RP, this is parallel combination and this is the result of parallel combination. Then this 2 and this 1 is in series and we write it equal to R. After this we get the quadratic equation and factors of quadratic equation are not possible. So we find the value of D. D is equal to P square minus 4AC. So this is under root D. Under root D we have calculated. And in the final result, we have the factors by, we can get the value of R by minus B plus minus under root D by 2A that you have studied in 10th class. So this we have used and after that we have calculated the value. So negative value is not possible, so we take only positive. So 1 plus under root 3 we have taken and the value of R comes out to be 2.73. And if I have to find the current now, then I will write I is equal to V by R. So voltage here given was 6 volt and the battery charge resistance comes out to 2.73. So in this way I can find the current. Students, I hope this question is clear. If you are feeling this video is useful to you, then you can share and like this video. So we have discussed this question now. And up to this point, we have discussed 3 questions. One question I have taken from S.L. Arora book. You can see the solution of that question also. But in that question, the internal resistance of battery is also there. So what we have to do today? Now we are going to the last question. Last question will be similar to this one. So let me see which is the last question. So this we have done, this we have done, this we have left. So this is the last question. Control C. Just wait for 1 minute. So students, we are moving to question last one. So this is our question number 4 here. I will try that we will complete it in few minutes. So this is our question number 4. What we will do here, circuit is repeating from, let me change the color. Okay, circuit is repeating from this point. Wait for a minute. Circuit is repeating from this point. After this, firstly 3 resistances, then again 3 resistances, then again 3 resistances. So what can I draw here? What will I draw? I will draw circuit 2 from this circuit 1. So I will draw one circuit, another circuit. So I am not taking battery here. I will take battery at the last. This is 2. Then again this is 2 and this is 2. Students, this is the first and last video for such type of questions. No further video will be available. I will give you some work, new work. Then you have to complete that work. Next video will be on the based of resistivity and stretching problems. So now I am taking it as stretching of wire and that type of questions. So this is 2 ohm, this 2 ohm, and the next 2 it is R, which is the effective resistance. Now students, follow the similar methods. Draw a circuit from this one. Now we will draw another circuit that will be like this one, 1 resistance 2 ohm, then 1 resistance here. That is a parallel combination of, that will be obtained by parallel combination of 2 and R. So this is R and 2. These are in parallel, so its resultant will be 1 by R plus 1 by 2. After taking the LCM and reciprocal, you will get this value as 2R by R plus 2. 2R by R plus 2. This value is 2. This value is also 2. The next step to this type of question is add these 3. This is in series with these 3 are in series. So what we do here, we will simply add them. So its value comes out to be 2R by R plus 2. So we have discussed 4 to 5 questions in this video. You can try some questions at your own end also, so that your concept will be clear. So adding these 3 and equating it equal to R. Now you will get quadratic equation. So I am writing quadratic equation here. So 2R on the left hand side plus 4 into R, 4R plus 4 into 2, 8 equal to R square plus 2R. So this will be the equation on the left hand side and right hand side. 2R will cancel out. So we are left with the equation R square minus 4R. So R square minus 4R minus 8. And this is equal to 0. Factors are possible. 4 to the 8. 4 to 8. No. Factors are not possible here again. So we will find the value of t. D is equal to b square minus 4ac. So b square minus 4ac is 4, 4 is the 16. So minus 4. This is the value of t. B square minus 4 into a into c. A's value is 1 and c's value is minus 8. So discriminant comes out to be 8 4s are 32, 34 plus 16, 48. So discriminant is 48. Now we have to find under root d, because we will use the under root d value for finding the roots. So under root d will be equal to 4 is the 16, 16 3 is the 48. So 4 under root 3 we can take. 4 is the 16 and 16 3 is the 48. So 4 under root 3 will be the value of under root d. Now we have to find the value of r. So r will be equal to minus b. So minus 4. Now plus minus discriminant under root d. So under root d is 4 root 3 by 2a. So 2a's value is 1. So we will write here 2. So our r will be equal to 2 plus minus 2 root 3. Students, now you can see, if I take here negative value, then this value right hand side 2 under root 3 will be greater than 2. So this will make it negative. That means we have to take a positive sign here. So 2 plus 2 under root 3 will be the resistance of this circuit. And if I have to find the current, I will check the first battery. So battery is of 6 volt. So that means if I have to find the current, then I will write here I equal to voltage by resistance. So 6 by 2 plus 2 under root 3 will be the value of current. You can find it by using calculator. So this we have to do. So you have to find the resistance and then find the value of current in such type of questions. I am repeating this last question again. Firstly, students, you have to see that from where the circuit is repeating. Like from this point, the circuit is repeating first 3 resistance, then again 3 resistance, then again 3 resistance. So that means after the 3 resistance, the circuit is repeating. So we make it as R, where R is the equivalent resistance of circuit. Now this R and this 2 is in parallel. So 1 by R plus 1 by 2 equal to 1 by RP, where RP is the parallel combination resistance of these two. So RP comes out to be, you can see RP comes out to be 2R by R plus 2, taking the LCM and reciprocal. Then this one and this one, these three resistances are in series. So we have taken the sum of them equal to R, then making a quadratic equation here and finding the value of discriminant. Discriminant will be b square minus 4ac. This is using b square minus 4ac, and 48 will be the discriminant, and we have to take under root d for finding the value of r. So here we are using minus b plus minus under root d by 2a, and after this I will get two values, 2 plus minus and 2 under root 3. So plus only positive is possible, so that's why we have taken it. And finally we have I equal to v by R. So in this video we have completed 4 questions, and one question I have given, we have seen from SL Arora book, and I will show you 1-2 more questions of such type. Wait for here. So students, you can see here we have taken a question from Vedantu PDF. So this is question number 21. Determine the current drawn from battery. So he is asking about the current drawn from battery. So this is similar question that is in SL Arora book. So you can pause the solution, pause and the video and see the solution. So he has taken after this repetition. Just wait. Okay, marker available. Yes. So students, what he is doing? What he is doing here? He has taken this as a battery and there is some internal resistance 0.5, but basically firstly he has to take this circuit. So firstly he has taken these three resistances. After these three the circuit is repeating, this three again this 3. So he has taken it as this one as R. Then R and 1 in parallel, then in series. So you can see the solution. I am just here for the solution part, so you can check the solution. He has taken this R, and this will be the solution for this question. You can see the solution and check. Okay, I hope you have noted down the solution. So now the last question I am giving you. One question to you in homework. So I have to go to paint. I hope this fourth question is clear. You can note down it. So now last question I am giving you. So question is this one. We are starting a circuit here. A resistance is there. Further resistance is there. And this is further one resistance is here. Another resistance is there. And then we have a resistance. This combination is up to infinity. Now students, note down the values of questions and points. This is point A. This is point A. This is point B. This has value 1 ohm. This resistance has value 2 ohm. And this resistance has value 3 ohm. Now again, for this question, for this section, 1 ohm, 2 ohm, and 3 ohm, and so on. So you have to find the value of equivalent resistance between point A and B. I hope this video is very useful to you, and if this video is useful, you can like and share this video with your friends. So thank you so much for joining here. In the earlier video, there is some mistake, so ignore it. And watch this video carefully. All the questions in this video are right. Thank you so much for joining the session, and if you really like this video, only then you can share it. Thank you so much. Have a nice day ahead. Bye bye students.